Today we're out searching for eastern indigo snakes that have been reintroduced to the preserve.
North America's largest native snake has all but disappeared from our area. Here at the Apalachicola Bluffs and Ravines Preserve, the Nature Conservancy and its partners are looking to bring it back.
We're right here, and we're going to walk to the south and check this area here, and then we'll walk back up to the north and check that area. And then Jen will stay in the middle, and then I'll go to the right, and we'll just kind of head to the end.
All right.
And if you get one, holler out. The indigos once were common all across southern Alabama, southern Georgia, and the entire state of Florida, even down into the Keys.
The eastern indigo snake is now mostly gone from the northern part of its range.
And the theory is it's because the gopher tortoises, which the indigos rely upon to escape the cold, to get into the burrows, the gopher tortoises have been eliminated from many of the conservation areas, or their populations are very depressed all across northern Florida.
The Nature Conservancy has spent 40 years restoring sandhills habitat to the Apalachicola Bluffs and Ravines Preserve. This open, fire-dependent landscape is ideal for gopher tortoises to make their burrows.
And now there is a quite robust population of gopher tortoises here at the Apalachicola Bluffs and Ravines Preserve. And for that very reason, the Eastern Indigo Snake Reintroduction Committee selected ABRP as the first reintroduction site in Florida.
They started releasing eastern indigos 3 years ago. The snakes are released into gopher tortoise burrows, and that's where we're looking for them today.
A small mammal had come and go out of this burrow. I suspect that is a fox or coyote den. That's impressive. So that's a fence lizard. That's a juvenile, and at that age, they eat just about anything that doesn't eat them.
How big do they get?
About three times that size.
At that size, is that something an indigo snake would eat?
Sure. This is something we really like to see. It's a tortoise burrow, and it's a juvenile tortoise burrow, which means that we are having reproduction. The gopher tortoise population is increasing. It's not very big.
Yeah.
And what's really neat is when you see the ones that are like this, you know, they're very small on the landscape. In the winter time, the animals come up to the sandhills, the uplands where the longleaf pine and wiregrass are, and in particular, that's where the gopher tortoise burrows are. In northern Florida, they need the burrows to escape the cold. This is also the time of year that they breed, probably as a result of them coming up into the uplands and aggregating. All right, here's something interesting. So, I would say pretty sure that there's an indigo in this burrow or somewhere right around here. Do you see this right here? That is a snake crawl. And because it, oh, I hear it. There he is. All right, then you push read. And there it is. And just as easy as that, we have the pit tag number for this snake.
Yeah.
So pretty.
This animal looks as if it is going to shed soon. The eyes are starting to get a little bit milky colored.
She's quite the character because we found her in the ravine, and she was in the ravine happily eating a banded water snake.
The one really great thing about indigos, for those that are scared of snakes, is they eat other snakes. In particular, the venomous ones, they really love diamondbacks and pygmy rattlesnakes and copperheads.
Here's a scene from the first indigo release here. Indigo snakes also eat non-venomous rat and corn snakes, which in turn eat songbirds. The Nature Conservancy hopes that releasing this apex predator will increase the number of birds in the preserve.
It's really cool. It's holding its tongue out for a long time.
Home again, Thanks for hanging out with us. For WFSU, I'm Rob Diaz de Villegas.
Down she goes.
For more videos and blog posts on the Sandhills habitat, the Apalachicola River corridor, and the many plants and animals that make this a top biodiversity hotspot, subscribe to the WFSU Ecology blog and Ecology YouTube channel.